It's meth and moonshine night here at Skinny B Johnson Stadium and International Speedway in Gristlejock, Georgia, where you can hear 13 minutes live version of Freebird five times a game, twice on the hour. Remember, in the NFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Atlanta Vultures take on the Yorks of Hazard. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you're just waking up wondering who put that vise on your head and filled your mouth with vacuum cleaner, dirt, and cat litter, you're not alone. After all, it's Sunday, NFL Game Day. Now, you look tired, Junior. And Bricks, you look like they just used your head in field goal practice.
Spent all night in the ER. We ate Chinese food last night.
Food poisoning?
I wish. I got the chopsticks lodged in my ears again. You know, they should have a warning on them things.
And it's first and ten.
Much like my wedding night, there was a big explosion, and then everyone left disappointed.
What do you mean, everyone? Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And they just popped his eyes in the back of his head. That quarterback could be hurting, or dead, or worse. Third down and never gonna happen. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the ball with the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Not much there, maybe a yard. Second down and nine. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Third down and nine. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he's got a chance for a good return here. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And that's how you run the football. A pickup of seven on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Nicely done for a first down. It's first and ten. And the defense jumps outside trying to mute.
It's not how many times you fall. It's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they ball wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
And it's first and ten. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. first down in a mile.
Welcome to McRoid Rage. How can I help you?
You've got to catch that. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Team hates it.
And it's first and 10. And he laterals the ball. Man, these guys follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. Hard. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it. Can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Third down and 6. Hit. And it's first and 10. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Second down in a very lot. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him.
It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
First down and 6. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. bring up second and one. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yay.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. First and 10. Second down and more than a cute. Whenever a player gets big like this, reminds me of that Tom Hitt. Oh, he took a leap and hit the ball, knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
And I'd like to say take the camera off him so he can just continue this game, but that's how we lost our last ever camera guys. Orcs really love their spotlight. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. He should have had that one. Second down and 10. Third down and the punter is warming up. Scrambler. And it's first and 10. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked out? What do you do then?
Run.
wrestles away from that tackle. And it's first and 10. And it's first and 10. And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. Second and 3. Nice hit. And it's first and 10. He runs it for 3. Second down and 7. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. Catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. First and 4. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. It's about a 3-yard pickup. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Friends, was an all-pro NFL hit.
Pinkman. They can have mine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex.
First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's for...
Yeah, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Third down and a pussy hair. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? I'm gonna go to a striptease show. Where we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. The defense better look out. The offense. Oh, he just got crushed. And that'll be second and 8 to go. That's a 6-yard gain. Third and 2. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gordon, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. Third down and 10. First down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
First down and six. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. And he picks up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one open, Bricks.
Yeah, and I nearly married Trim Bagassian. And I nearly did not crap my pants earlier. Nearly as overrated, Grin.
Second down, the size of Bricks Wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. Second down in a mile.
Hot one, hot two. Hey.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick it in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. That ought to stop them.
Third and 4. Looks like the defense called the ginormous dirty trick. That's a hole. Oh, and the lineman bats the ball away with his meaty paw for an incomplete pass. Great play. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just get the points and let's move on.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. Stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. Oh, what a brutal hit! Third down and a sliver.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and 10. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And it's first and 10. And he punched his way out, and he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. Third down and long. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. First and 10. The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. Second down and 5. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to kill the quarterback. You know, in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, yeah, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. The offense has only 2 quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. And it's first and 10. Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
There was an explosion, but everyone's walking away from it.
Them cool guys always walk away from explosions.
Hey, that might be good for the movies, but it's awful for the NFL.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
First and 4. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now.
Kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for 2.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Can't think of any yours.
The defense comes up big, stopping a 2-point attempt.
Just one.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and ten. When the defense calls Thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go, Don't Treat the Yellow Snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crab Apple Trees, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her low intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
Oh, you're telling me.
The defense is back on their heels, and the offense just keeps rolling. And it's first and ten. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and ten. And that's a nice run for a first down. First and ten. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and ten. In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. The extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick.
I thought they were going to do some sort of chorus line.
First and ten. He picks up five on that play. The defense calls timeout. They must be trying to get on their QB's good side. Second down and five. Picks up maybe four on that play. A timeout is called by the defense to stop the clock. They have one remaining. Third and two. Conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and ten. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
That hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. You've got to catch that. The Hazard is victorious and they are celebrating on the field. That's ugly. They come up big today with a solid win and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
My own wounds taste just like chicken. How was it, scrambles, tomato soup? I forget, but a good scab tastes like bacon. That I know.
A scab lettuce tomato sandwich. Sounds like a picnic. And the MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.